Good morning students. In chemistry chapter 4, the next topic we are going to study is valency. In our last class we have studied the Bohr and Bury scheme about the electron distribution, and from there we know that outermost shell of an atom can accommodate a maximum of 8 electrons. Okay, now what is valency? Valency can be defined as the combining capacity of the atoms of other elements. Okay, when the elements combine, whatever is their combining capacity, that is known as valency. That is their tendency to react and form molecules. Okay, when elements they react and they form molecule, their tendency to combine with each other is known as valency. Okay, and they can form molecules with atom of the same element or with atoms of different elements. So I'm explaining it further. This was the definition of valency. Now it is explained as an attempt to attain a fully filled outermost shell. What does it mean? That each atom, every atom, it has a tendency that it wants to attain a fully filled outermost shell. Fully filled means it should be complete with 8 electrons. We know that in outermost shell maximum electrons can accommodate, that is 8. So to attain a fully filled outermost shell means to attain 8 electrons in their outermost shell. So each element has this tendency. Okay, for to achieve this tendency, what do they do? An outermost shell which had 8 electrons was said to possess an octet. This tendency of attaining 8 electrons in their outermost shell is known as octet. Octet means fulfill of outermost shell with 8 electrons. Octa means 8. Okay, when the outermost shell is filled with 8 electrons, it means that element has achieved an octet, or we can say its octet is complete. Now, atoms would so react so as to achieve an octet in the outermost shell. So different atoms will react, and why do they react? They want to achieve an octet, means 8 electrons in their outermost shell. Okay, so how do they do this? For this, either they have to share electrons, or they will gain electrons, or they will lose electron. So how will we find out that they will lose electron, gain electron, or share electron? By writing their electronic configuration or electron distribution, which we have learnt in Bohr and Bury scheme. Okay, and then we will find out that to complete the octet of electrons, they will lose electron or gain electron or share electron. So I'm to explain it in a better way, I'm explaining here some example. For example, let's take the example of lithium. Okay, what is its electronic configuration? KL. In K there are 2 electrons and in L 1. Why? Because total number of electrons are 3. Now we have to see its outermost shell. Okay, so how many electrons are there in outermost shell? 1. Okay, so to attain a fully filled outermost shell, that is first shell, K shell can have maximum of 2 electrons only. So it is fully filled. So to attain a fully filled outermost shell, it can lose 1 electron. Okay, so it will lose 1 electron. So when it will lose 1 electron, its outermost shell will be fully filled. Okay, so for that he has lost 1 electron, so its valency will be 1. Okay, see the other example, that is sodium. Sodium atomic number 11, or total number of electrons are 11. So what will be the electronic configuration? 2 8 1, that is KLM 2 8 1. Now here again it can lose 1 electron. okay, if it will lose this electron, then in the outermost shell it will be 8 electron, that is its octet will be complete. So again it will lose one electron, and its valency will be 1. Okay, so valency is the number of electron lost or gained or shared. So here the valency will be 1. Take the next example, magnesium. Magnesium atomic number 12. Okay, so electronic configuration will be 2, 8, 2. So to what it will try? It will try to achieve 8 electron in the outermost shell. So for this it has to lose 2 electron. Okay, so it is losing 2 electron, so its valency will be 2. Okay, next example is phosphorus. Phosphorus, that is number of electrons are 15. So electronic configuration is 2, 8, 5. Now here to lose 5 electron, it is better for phosphorus to accept 3 electrons. Okay, if it will accept 3 electrons here, then also its outermost shell will have 8 electron. So it is difficult to lose 5 electron, and it is a better option to gain 3 electron. So if it gain 3 electron, its outermost shell will have 8 electrons, so its octet will be complete. So what it has done, it has gained 3 electrons. So it has gained 3 electrons, so its valency will be 3. Okay, see the other case, sulfur. Here the number of electrons are 16. Okay, so the electronic configuration is 2, 8, 6. It is also the same case. Okay, it is not possible to lose so many electrons, that is 6 electrons. So it is better to gain 2 electrons to complete it octet. Okay, so it is gaining 2 electrons to complete it octet. It will gain 2 electrons, so its valency will be 2. Same in the case with chlorine, that is 17. 2, 8, 7. So it's better to accept or gain 1 electron to fulfill its outermost shell, that is to complete its octet. So it will gain 1 electron, so its valency will be 1. Okay, so what do we conclude? We conclude is that valency is basically it is the combining capacity of an element. Okay, how combining capacity? That is, they want to always achieve an octet, that is outermost shell should have 8 electrons. For that they will lose electron or they will gain electron. So how many electron they will lose or how many electron they will gain, that will be called its valency. Okay, so this is the concept of valency, that is the combining capacity of an atom. Thank you.